Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Director General Jonathan Castaneda. I am conducting an interview with His Majesty, the Royal King, Tiburcio Villamor Marcos Tallano Tagean IV. Our topic for today is about the establishment of El Banco Español Filipino in the Philippines. Your Majesty, who was instrumental for the establishment of El Banco Español Filipino II?
This bank that originated and it becomes El Banco Español Filipino Isabel II has also an El Banco Español Filipino Isabel II offshore bank. The bank by itself has been established by Queen Isabella II of Spain, being a recipient for and in behalf of the Filipina or Filipino archipelago for that purpose.
So, what is your relationship with Queen Isabella II?
Queen Isabella is my great grandmother. She's a great grandmother towards our family with the Roman Empire through the leadership of my great-great-great-great-grand-grand-grand-grandfather, Emperor Marcus Ulpius Trajanus Trajan of Rome. This family, they are the Habsburg family of King of Kings, all the way down to King Philip II of England and Spain, married to my great great grandmother, Queen
You're referring to who?
The wife of King Ferdinand II.
As far as I know,
it was actually
Queen Isabella,
Mary Tudor,
the first.
I believe the second. Mary Tudor II.
The second.
The Queen of Two Sicilies and the Queen of Regents in England. The real Queen of England within the Habsburg family, all the way down to Queen Isabella and King Ferdinand VII of Spain. So these are my predecessors, whereby Queen Isabella II establishes the El Banco Español Filipino Isabel II and El Banco Español Filipino Isabel II offshore bank for the intercontinental or the global bullion bank of the world, called El Banco Español Filipino Isabel II.
Is it true that El Banco Español Filipino Isabel II became the Bank of the Philippine Islands?
Actually, that's one of the banks that has been established by El Banco Español. But before then, El Banco Español, Isabel II, here in the Philippines, in 1950, they chartered the Central Bank of the Philippines through the capitalization of El Banco Español, Filipina Isabel II.
How much was the capitalization?
That capitalization was actually, first it was gold that has been deposited as an initial capitalization, and that was like about 617,000 metric ton of gold. This gold come from the asset of the king of recognized asset nations that originated actually from the asset of the Roman Empire.
Who was the person behind for the establishment of the original Central Bank of the Philippines?
The original Central Bank in 1950, it was actually my mother, Princess Queen and Amesia Cruzan Villamor Tagliano, who's been actually instrumental to put together the Central Bank of the Philippines, and it has been helped by leaders all over the world. And that's where President Truman got involved. The President of the Philippines during that time was actually Elpidio Quirino. More so, it was my mother and leaders all over the world. Leaders of China. We have Chiang Kai-shek that got involved, the premier, Chou Enlai, the president, and the supreme commander of China, the supremo, was actually Mao Zedong that helped this process be part of the Central Bank of the Philippines, and also the premier of Spain, Franco himself, a leader, and the head of Spain. But so, there are other testators, such as Sergio Osmania Sr. as one of the major trustees of this asset that has been lodged properly chartered as an El Banco Español Filipino Isabel II, but it becomes now Central Bank of the Philippines. And with the other testators, like Princess Maria Cristina Cruzan Villamor Tagliano, and one of my great grandmother at the same time, Princess Maria Isabel III, and then my mother, as one of the testators, Princess Anemesia, cousin of Eliamor Tagliano, witnesses, and testators as well as our trust depositors, Jose Antonio Severino Santa Romana, I have Tanka K as well as one of the trust depositors that signed the agreement. My father, at the same time, served as a testator. In short, she served as legal counsel of the family. I'm referring now to my father, Ferdinand Edraline Marcos.
So, how you inherited the original Central Bank of the Philippines, which is different from the Banco Central ng Pilipinas?
This bank served as a gold bullion bank, and it has deposits of the asset of the king of recognized asset nation. I'm referring now to the Central Bank of the Philippines. The 617,000 metric ton, and during those years that they have chartered, my family deposited
356 million dollars.
US dollars as a major capitalization of the Central Bank of the Philippines in 1950. More so, the family overall capitalization for the Hacienda Filipina Archipelago, and they're the auspices of eminent ancestral domain of the OCT T01-4. We have a total capitalization, family capitalization of the $5 trillion, and we have all the gold in our family.
I think another amount is 9 trillion, if I'm not mistaken.
More so, what I understand.
So what is the current value of $356 million deposited in the past?
In the past,
today, the current value?
$356 million, I believe we have an escrowed funds with Development Bank of the Philippines, or perhaps with land bank, easily like about within the tune of the perhaps all the way up to like about 100 trillion.
So
US dollars equivalent.
So what are the banks where the money is now escrowed?
Now these funds, we have so much, all the way up to the Federal Reserve US Treasury. So today, the amount that will be used to bankroll the whole world through all this asset that has been accumulated, both the spiritual funds and these accumulated assets, we have today to bankroll ECOSOC, or the embodiment of this, the whole national global economic development infrastructure. We have initially 500 dodecillion.
Dodecalion.
Or dodecalion, for that matter. we have these funds available now. We have the backup gold to bankroll the central banks of central banks of the whole world. There are like about 209 central banks of the whole world. They are ready, willing, and able to make sure that this will be bankrolled through the monetary system and through a global monetary reset governance of the whole world.
So, thank you very much for this highly informative interview, Your Majesty and Royal King Tiburcio Villamor Marcos Tagean Tallano IV. We will discuss in the succeeding interview about your plans for funding your United Nations global humanitarian and international economic development programs through Project ECOSOC. Thank you very much, Your Majesty. Your message for the at least 108 million Filipino people?
Well then, as I've been trying to overemphasize, I'm ready, willing, and able to share it to all of Filipinos, 100 million plus Filipinos. I'm here. We'll have a better life. And we have everything. We're very rich back here in our country. We'll make sure nobody will be deprived. And I'm ready to share it with everyone, with pride, prestige, and dignity, and for the good of all of us. We have the blessings of our Lord Jesus Christ, Allah, Jehovah. In Lord Jesus, we trust.
Mga kababayan, narinig niyo po ang napakagandang mensahe ni Emperor at Royal King Tiburcio Villamor Marcos Tagean Tallano IV para sa sambayan ng Pilipino. At sana po ay tangkilikin niyo ang aming video series tungkol sa kanyang magandang adhikain upang mayangat ang mga Pilipino sa kahirapan. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pakikinig at pagsubaybay.
Maraming salamat po sa inyo lahat.